Hello class, this is your teacher and I'm going to show you in this tutorial how to edit to make a video using Final Cut Pro. So these are the steps that you need to write down and commit to your memory right now. So go ahead and pause this tutorial and write these steps down in your notebook and also add them to your video journal on your Weebly. The first step is to cut or blade in and out points. And by that I mean, will you want your video to start in your clip and end in your clip? So you may have a clip that's 5 minutes long, but you may only want to start it in the 2 minute start point and stop it at the 4 minute because you did some extra recording at the beginning and at the end. So in that situation, you want to set your in and out points for that clip, and I will show you how to do that in just a second. The second step is once you set your in and out points, you're going to place it in timeline. Let me go back to the first step. To set an endpoint is simply very easy. All you have to do is hit I on the keyboard and it starts your endpoint. Then to set your out point, you hit O and that's it. And you'll see your clip, the yellow border around your clip will set for that at that point. Now, let's say you have two or three in and out points in one clip. That's okay. You can hit Command Shift I to set the second one and Command Shift O to set the second one. So you see it's very easy to do that. I know you don't understand what I'm saying right now, but I'm about to show you. The second step is once you set those points is to drop them down, bring them down to the timeline. So place all those in the timeline. Then you're going to repeat that process until you've viewed all your footage. And then you're going to view your footage. Step 4 and 5 is place sequential video in timeline. So you're going to be viewing it and then you're going to rearrange it if you need to, put it in order that you want it to be in. Okay? So now let's take a look at this. Alright, let's look up here and I've just pulled up. Let me find an event here that I want to use as an example. Okay, so let's say that I viewed these clips, and in this clip right here, for example, if I click on the whole clip, okay, and then hit there's three buttons that you can use to insert clips into your storyline. You can either hit the first one, which says connect the selected clip to the primary storyline. You can hit insert the selected clip in the primary storyline, or you can hit append the clip to the primary storyline or the selected storyline, E. So if I wanted to move this clip down, you can also just drag and drop it. Okay, but I may not want the whole clip. I may only want a section of the clip. So the way you set your in and out points is while you're viewing it, okay, and my screen is a little smaller because I have it set. You need to kind of move it around so you can see the preview browser right here while you're doing it so it will show up. But let's just say that I want to start it right here. So I hit I. Then I want to stop it right here. So I hit O. There's my in and out. Okay. And I want to bring it down to the timeline. So all I have to do is hit that button. And it's there. Okay. That's it. That's all you have to do. All right. So that's how you set your in and out points. Now let me show you if you want to set more than one in and out. Let's start right here and hit an I. Hit O, and then I want to start right here. Hit an I. Uh-oh, what'd I forget? I forgot to hit my command button. All right, so I'm going to start again. Start right here. Hit my I for N. And if my screen was a little bit bigger, you could kind of see what's going on over here. You kind of want to have this window a little bit bigger so you can see what it's doing. Okay. And I've got this set to where I can't see it. because I have my screen right here so big, but I don't have it on full screen, so that's why too. All right, so I set my I, set my O, I'm going to set it right here. It's my O. Now I'm going to do another one. I'm going to hit, this time, the right key, Command-Shift-I, and I want it right here. Command-Shift-O. Now I have two in and out points on the same clip, and I want to bring those down. I can either drag them down, or I like to hit the, it says E there. Let me see if I can hit E. It works. So the E is the quick key to bring that down. The E on the keyboard. Okay. This is insert the clips in the primary storyline of the selected storyline. That's W key. Or you can hit this one for Q. And it connects the selected clip to the primary storyline. Let me show you what that one does. Okay, that one shows up on top. So if you wanted to fade, if you wanted to use a cutaway to get it something in there, while you're also using the audio for the second clip, you could put it on top. Whatever's on top shows up first. Okay, and then okay, you see how these work. This one's showing up on top. This one's going in, and then this one connects it at the back. Okay. All right, so that's how you edit. Set your in and outs, place them in timeline, keep doing that until you get all your clips reviewed, view your footage, see if you like it, and then reorder them in the timeline, place sequential clips in order. So once you view it, you may say, okay, I want these clips here in front, so I want to move those in front, okay. I can click them and drag them and rearrange them, okay, to put those in front. All right, that's the basics of editing. That shows you how to get your footage in, how to set your in and out points, place them in timeline, and on the next tutorial, I'll show you some more information on how to add titles and graphics and transitions and all kind of fun stuff, okay? All right, let me go ahead and, while I'm thinking about the keyboard shortcuts, this is a very good graphic on the different keys that you can use. Notice all your tools are in yellow, your B for blade, your Z for zoom, your A to select, your H for hand, trim is T, P is position, and you simply just hit those keys and it changes that tool. It's very fast, very efficient, and notice your keyboard is your space bar is your play and stop. And anything in the red color, you have to hold down the command and hit that. So command 2 would be timeline, command 3 viewer, command 4 inspector, and so on and so forth. And so I'll give you a copy of this so you can keep in your notebook, but this is a great way to speed up the edit process if you know the shortcut keys. So go ahead right now and write down some of them so that way you can be faster on your edits, be more efficient, and impress me. All right. Thank you for watching, and until next time, happy editing.